A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 19th April, on the front page you have 67% turnout in second phase of Lok Sabha polls. So this is regarding the Lok Sabha elections which took place for various seats in the following states, and the voter turnout is shown here. You can see a high voter turnout has been seen in, that is 78% in Puducherry and 71% in Tamil Nadu, the Tamil Nadu by-elections. Then this is government suspends cross LOC trade after misuse of by arms drug smugglers. So across the line of control, there was trade going on between Jammu and Kashmir and the Indian territory plus the Pakistan occupied Kashmir. But now the government has suspended this cross LOC trade, saying there is misuse by arms and drug smugglers. Then below you have CSIR plans genome sequencing to map population. So CSIR has initiated efforts to investigate link of genome with diseases. So indigenous genetic mapping would take place. So it is said nearly 1,000 rural youth from length and breadth of India will have their genome sequenced by CSIR. So project aims at educating the generation of students on the usefulness of genomics too. Many countries have undertaken such genome sequencing actually because of, you know, their citizens, what are the unique genetic traits of their citizens, and their susceptibility to various diseases, resilience to various diseases is understood through this genome sequencing. So this is the first time such a large sample of Indians will be recruited for a detailed project. It's around, you can see, it's actually a part of much larger government-led program which is still being worked on, which will sequence at least 10,000 Indian genomes. On page 5 you have officials allow some persons to cast tendered votes in Tamil Nadu. So this is a case which happened here in Tamil Nadu, in which some persons' votes were already cast. They were shocked to find that their votes had already been cast, but officials allowed them to cast their votes as well. So here you can see, according to the conduct of election rules, a voter is allowed to cast a tendered vote where someone else representing to be a particular voter has already cast that vote. So allowed the actual voter to vote as such if he was able to prove his identity through the ballot paper. So ballot paper was used in such cases. Then on page 7 you have Hindustan Aeronautics Limited resumes tests of jet trainer. So these tests were halted in 2016 because the aircraft encountered problems in the spin test. But now this Hindustan Aeronautics Limited intermediate jet trainer in a modified version has been ready, and now it is going to have its test flights resumed. This is plea in Supreme Court on voting rights of under trials and convicts. So this is a petition filed in Supreme Court by a law student questioning the electoral law which denies under trials and convicts their right to vote. The petition says it violates their right to equality. Then this is Indians in Libya told to be careful. So we know the Libyan crisis which is presently been unfolding. So Indians have been told to be careful about the situation. And this is after J&J case, government treats carefully. So control samples for imported drugs may be made mandatory. So government will make it mandatory for import license holders to monitor, to maintain control samples of these imported drugs. On the editorial page, the first editorial is hard landing. So this is regarding Jet Airways, what we saw on front page yesterday. So the airlines must take stock of their collective plight and sell seats at the real cost. So this is what the editorial is suggesting. And second editorial, Beijing surprise. So this says that the Chinese economy has grown faster than expected, but concerns over stimulus still remain. So that is there, because when fiscal stimulus is given and growth is pushed, then it can become unsustainable. The lead article, a shameful marker of 5 years. So this is regarding India's dubious contribution to a global epidemic of hate. That is, you know, these mob lynchings. So it is, 5 years to this initiation of such cases of mob lynchings. Then this is predictable chaos in Libya. So this is regarding the Iraqi-Libyan interventions which are being seen, like the intervention in Libya, intervention in Iraq. So these such species of intervention, such types of intervention with UN approval but under Western watch. So UN approves it, but then the Western countries control it. The article says that this is a post-Cold War phenomenon, that post-Cold War we are seeing such interventions taking place, Western controlled interventions taking place. So that has been, you know, a critique has been written here on that, and the chaos which it causes in the country, in such countries. Then on the op-ed page on Fridays, you have this parley coverage in which a question is put forth and there are two viewpoints given. So the question is the Election Commission toothless or is it refusing to bite? So on its powers and limitations of on the powers and limitations of Election Commission in conducting free and fair elections, you can see the views given here by when former Chief Election Commissioner S.Y. Qureshi. On international page, you have Barr releases Mueller probe report. So this is regarding the Mueller report, which has been prominently in news, in which, you know, the links between Trump administration and even the Trump campaigning team and the Russian intervention in US presidential elections has been investigated, and whether President Trump tried to, you know, interfere in the investigations or stall the investigations. So this is the Mueller report on that. So this has, yeah, this was in news, but the report was not released. So presently you can see that this special counsel Robert Mueller's report has been on his inquiry into Russia's role in 2016 US elections, you know, detailing even a series of actions by President Trump to halt the probe or to affect the probe. So this has now been released. It's a 448-page report. And below you have Amazon to shut down operations in China. So there is tough competition, and now Amazon has said it will shut its China online store by July 18th. Then on page 14, you have IT department proposes new norms for taxing MNCs, multinational companies. So weightage would be given to factors like local sales in taxing them. Then on the last page, you have top UK honor for Indian scientists. So this is CIPLA chairman Yusuf Hamid. He is on this year's list of Royal Society fellows. So he has been honored by the Royal Society, which is an independent scientific academy of the UK and Commonwealth, which is dedicated to promoting excellence in science. And this is Google lets Android users in Europe choose rival browsers. So this is a step being taken by Google to address concerns and stave off sanctions. So now European users actually can, Android users can choose rival browsers too. They don't have to choose just Chrome. And this is HIV used to fix bubble boy disease. So this is seen in children, toddlers. So they die with infection within a year or two of birth without treatment. So now this boy born with this working germ fighting system, in which every infection is a threat to his life. So there was no working germ fighting system in him. So every disease became a threat. So this such babies have now been treated. So this is gene therapy which has been used, and one of them, one of the immune system's worst enemies, that is HIV, as such has been fixed. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasia.com and download current affairs PDFs, daily PDFs too. The keywords initiative also can be available. Thank you.